every celebration we have through the course of the year is special in its own way. But the celebration that we are honored to be a part of in the next few days or weeks is very unique, because we go through a cycle of emotions unlike any other time during the year. It begins with our Lord's triumphal entry into Jerusalem and the excitement of the crowd who were ready to proclaim him as their Messiah. But that didn't last very long, because by the middle of the week, he was participating in the Last Supper with his disciples, only then to be in agony in the Garden of Eden, in the Garden of Gethsemane. And then we know we find him on the old rugged cross, being crucified in such a cruel manner. But for all of the despair, we find hope on Easter morning when we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. But through it all, one fact stands out. Jesus Christ is King of Kings. It's not a matter of one day he's going to be. It's a matter of he is King of Kings. It's just the fact that one day the whole world is going to know that he is King of Kings. And so as you listen tonight to the message and song that the sanctuary choir has prepared, and when I say prepared, I do mean they have spent countless hours and unlimited effort in order to be the servants of the Lord and the messenger of Jesus Christ for this moment. We just so appreciate their director, Ms. Phyllis Dotson, the dedication of each and every one who, fruit of their labors, will be evident to you tonight. And they do this with one goal in mind, that somebody will come to know Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. And so whether you be present in the sanctuary tonight or are listening via Facebook or YouTube, we're honored that you've joined us tonight, because we know you're going to be blessed. And if tonight anyone who has not made that decision to trust Christ will do that, what a blessing that will be. It will be the blessing of all blessings to know that their labors have not been in vain, and only eternity will reveal the fruit of their labors. Our precious Father, we bow tonight into your presence, thanking you for the privilege and the honor of being in your service. Lord, it's wonderful to know that we've come to saving faith in Jesus Christ, but that would be empty and meaningless if we did not have the opportunity to serve our Lord in some capacity. Thank you that you have so gifted these people with the ability to share the message and song, and they are so willing and so free to use that gift for your honor and for your glory. It is a message that can never be told too often. Jesus Christ, King of Kings. Father, we lift up our voices in praise and adoration to you tonight, knowing that the very heavens are observing everything that is said and done, and we know it's going to be done in order that Jesus Christ may be glorified. To God be the glory. Great things he hath done, our King of Kings. Amen.
I wanted to let you know that this is a musical that we chose because it invites the congregation to sing along on any of the hymns that you're familiar with. So please join us as we sing these many familiar hymns. And also, it's okay to clap. We do that on Sunday morning, and you're certainly welcome to do that tonight.
We'll be right back. blessed and over and only sovereign. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He alone is immortal, and he is invisible. But Jesus Christ was the image of this unreachable God. He was fully God and fully man, so he possessed all of the characteristics of his Father, all of God's power, all of his perfection, and all of his authority.
Yeah.
Though Jesus was one with God in heaven, he would become a suffering servant on earth. Since we have all strayed from God, he chose to provide a way back to bring us.
Alas, and in my Savior plead, and in my Sovereign die, would he devote that sacred head for sinners such as
I? And the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden.
love of Christ surpasses our knowledge. The length and width, height and depth of God's love is beyond our comprehension. He poured out his love into our hearts. Therefore, nothing can ever separate us from God's love, not death or life, angels or demons, our fears for today or our worries about tomorrow. Even the powers of hell cannot take us from his everlasting love.
Yeah.
died for our sins, and he was buried, and he was raised on the third day. God has not only raised the Lord, but he will also raise us up through his power. He made us alive together with Christ. So great is the love the Father has given us that we should be called his children, and if children, also heirs. Heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ.
Thank you.
Given musical that the Sanctuary Choir presents, there's always challenges, and I'd be safe to say that there's probably not been a practice from the very beginning where everyone was present at the same time. But nonetheless, the Lord has a way of bringing it all together, and surely He has done that tonight. We say that about our worship service on Sunday. We say it about everything we do for the Lord. You put your best effort and trust the Lord to do the rest. We regret tonight there are a couple of members of the Sanctuary Choir who providentially hindered from being here, Cindy Cordova and Francis Milner, or any others or not. But I want to thank those two audio and video technicians who are here. Neil Sherrill and Amanda Burriss. Amen. Amen. They are the ones who tell me they can cut me off anytime they want. So we just thank the Lord for your participation tonight. We pray that this has been a blessing to you as it has to me. And there's no question the Lord has been honored here tonight. Jesus Christ has been glorified. And for anyone who does not know the Lord, I don't know how they could listen to this and not realize that something has to change in their life. So with that, we pray God's blessings to you as you go. If you do not have a church home, we welcome you to come and worship with us as the Lord leads you. And we just thank you once again for your commitment here tonight in your presence. Father, we bow in your presence tonight, just saying to God be the glory. Great things He hath done, reminding us once again through the ministry of music, the dedication of these who have spent countless hours preparing for these moments, that Jesus Christ is the King of Kings. He is Lord of Lords. We know that from personal experience, and there will come a day when everyone will know that. We just thank you, Father, that we have God's promises of His presence, of His blessings in everything we do. Beyond that, we cannot go. More than that, we cannot ask. And so we just ask you tonight to use what has been presented here tonight for your honor and your glory. The seed has been sown. It's going to be exciting now to watch God bring the harvest and the increase. In his name we pray. Amen.
Once we were enemies of God, but because of Jesus, we are reunited with our Father. We were strangers, but now citizens of God's eternal kingdom. We were dead in sin, but we are alive in him. That is who we are. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Now to the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen.
Said.
Jesus Christ is King of Kings.
Amen. All right. Thank you all.